Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Mesillas Yesharim, and today we're beginning Perek Yud Ches, the 18th chapter in the Sefer Midas HaChasidus, the trait of Chasidus of piety. Midas HaChasidus Zichri Be'emes Lever Gonel. In truth, this trait of Chasidus of piety requires a very grand explanation. Ki min hagim rabim udrachim rabim oivrim bein rabim mibnei adam b'shem chasidus. There are many different things that people do, and all in the name of piety. Ve'einam ela gami chasidus. However, they're really empty actions and forms of chasidus, of what a person believes is making him pious, but it's not. Bli tayar, bli tzur, bli tikon. It lacks the shape and the form and the ability to be called something that's really chasidus. And the reason that people do this is because they're lacking the time spent wisely to examine what exactly chasidus is. Now, chasidus doesn't mean to be a chasidus yid. Doesn't mean to have a long payas and a long beard and a long frock and a strimal on the head. That's not what chasidus means. Chasidus, as we're going to see, loosely translated in English, is piety, which is going to be a very high and lofty level in the world of Avodas Hashem. But the reason that people make mistakes is because they're lacking the understanding. They don't understand what they're supposed to accomplish with Chasidus. They didn't spend enough time and work hard enough to understand the Das, to know the Derech Hashem, the pathway of Hashem, be yediyah brua v'yishara, in a clear and straight way. Rather, whatever they thought initially is the proper way to become a chassid, to become a person of piety, that's a devoutly pious individual, that's what they did. They never delved deep into the ideas and the concepts over here, and they didn't weigh it out on the scales of wisdom properly. Whatever they thought would make them pious, that's what they did. Unfortunately, such people, they spoil the reach, the spirit of chasidus in the eyes of everybody else. And even those people that begin to understand a little bit what it means, because people will watch you trying to be a chassid, they'll see you do things that you hold make you a person of great piety, and they'll think, oh, that's what it takes, that's what a person has to do, even though there's many things that the person is doing that has nothing, it goes completely against seichel, it goes completely against logic and proper thinking. They think that, how does a person become a chassid, a pious individual? They have amiras, bakashas, rabbis. They have to say a lot of tehillim, viduim gedolim. They have to constantly confess all their sins to our Kodesh Baruch Hu. Or bechiyos, they have to break down and cry all the time. Vishtachavayos, gedolos, they have to prostrate themselves. Ubasigufim azorim, sheyomis b'ma'adim ezatzmai. And they afflict themselves physically, and they destroy their body through their acts of achieving piety, and they can kill themselves as a result. Like, for example, ketevilas hakerech v'ashelig, a person wants to go to the mikvah, and he goes in the frigid winter time, in the Russian winters over there, and he breaks the ice, and he goes into the mikvah, and he causes himself to freeze, and to his body to go through convulsions, all for the sake of breaking his body, because that's what it means to be a chassid. V'chayotzi b'dvar me'ele. Similar things. Says the Ramchal, that's what it means to be a chassid. That's what HaKadosh Baruch Hu might know. V'nei lo yedu ki af al pishik tzatz dvar me'ele tzvichim lebali tshuva. It's true, says the Ramchal. Some of these actions are needed for people that are bali tshuva, they sinned, and they have to rectify their sins. So perhaps they might need to do something that will be a bit of a pain on their body. It will cleanse the body from its mistaken actions. Uktasim roin the prushim, and those people that are prushim, as we discussed, those people that abstain from the pleasure of the physical world, maybe, perhaps, they'll have to do a little bit of these things. Hine le'al But you should know, this is not what Chasidus, what piety is based upon. Maybe, says the Ramchal, maybe the best of these minhagim, of these actions over here, perhaps will find its way into the world of Chasidus. A little bit. Ach mitzius ha-chasidus atzmai. But the essence of what it means, piety, hudavar omog ma'oid la'avino al-nochain, it is so deep in order for a person to understand it properly. When meyusar al-yusod es chachma rabba, it is based upon very deep foundations of wisdom, v'tikvan ha-maisa betachlis, and a person rectifying and correcting his actions in the highest level possible. Asher roi lechem lekol chacham lev lidlev acharav. And therefore, anyone with a chacham lev, a wise heart, like we find in this week's parsha, the people that built the Mishkan were chacham lev, they had wise hearts. Anybody who has a heart that is wise, he wants to truly understand what Chasidus is, and he will chase after it in the proper way. Ki rak lechachamim la'asiga b'em, as only wise people will be able to achieve this in truth. V'chein amuzal, like our sages teach us, v'loi am ha'aretz chosid, an ignoramus cannot be a chosid, cannot be a person of piety. If you have no wisdom, you'll think that rolling around in the snow without your clothing and going into frigid mikvahs and crying all day long over your sins, you'll think that's the way to chasidus. But it's not. The way to do it is what we're going to explain. Unavayr ata inyan zal seda, now we're going to explain things according to the order here. And therefore, says the Ramchal, let me just dispel any preconceived notions or rumors that you have. To become a person of chasidus, of piety, don't think it means damaging and hurting and afflicting yourself. If those are things, as he has written already and will continue to speak out, those are things that have go against logic and go against reasoning. To be a chassid is the highest level in avodas Hashem. It must mean that it comes with tremendous chachma, with wisdom and knowledge and understanding, and that way a person will be able to reach a new zenith in their service of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Have a wonderful day, a wonderful Shabbos, and may you be zeichah to find the chacham lev, the heart of wisdom inside of you.